My name's Abeo Powder. I'm from Chelsea, Massachusetts, and I'm running the New York City Half Marathon.
When your heart is broken down, down, down.
You can be whatever you want to be.
And your head don't reach the sky.
You can do whatever you want to do. If you put your heart and soul in it, run, girl, run that mess out of this life.
Take your broken wings and fly.
Well, it initially started off as something to check off a bucket list, 25 before 25 type of deal. But the more I really did my research, I realized I wanted to run for a greater cause than myself. So I chose the Leukemia Lymphoma Society to run on behalf of. So that was my biggest motivation. And I know a lot of people who have been affected by leukemia and lymphoma. My mother being one of those individuals, and she's rallying along with many others, and unfortunately some have succumbed to the disease, but we're out here, we're running, we're raising funds, we're raising awareness, and that was my biggest motivation.
This might sound cliche, and everybody says this about their mom, but my mom is really the strongest woman that I know. I see her take on every day with just such strength and optimism. Even when she knows she might not be able to accomplish something, she's still keeping a positive outlook and trying to get as far as she possibly can. And when she was first diagnosed with multiple myeloma in 2007, I remember being in that hospital room, and when I first saw her, we were both very emotional, and even despite all the crying, I could still see some optimism in her eyes. And I remember her telling her doctor, we're gonna take care of this and we're gonna beat this thing. And thank God she's been in remission, and we couldn't be more grateful for that. We couldn't be more grateful for the tremendous medical staff who's taken such great care of her, and the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. I mean, my mom is truly my inspiration and one of the biggest reasons for me running this half marathon and the cause that I'm running behind.
It's that literal and figurative finish line, knowing that I'm gonna accomplish a great feat. And I mean, running is all I know. I've been running since I was 5, so that just that sense of accomplishment, you know, knowing that, hey, you know, if I don't wake up and I don't get out there and train, I don't head to the gym, that's one less day that I have to really go after that goal. And again, it's physical, but it's mental. It's mental preparation, it's physical preparation. It'll definitely hold a special place in my heart because I, you know, it's a greater cause of myself that I'm running for. And just hearing that crowd pump me up and seeing my friends and my family out there, I mean, I already know I'm going to be an emotional mess. It happened in Boston, and I'm sure it'll happen here. It's not location exclusive, so I know it'll be so many emotions running through my mind. I'll be crying because I'm in pain. I'll be crying because I'm just so happy to, you know, accomplish this, and it's gonna be a great day. I'm getting psyched about it already.
It's a lot.
it's a lot. Understanding that, you know, you need to pace yourself. You can't bite off more than you can chew in the beginning because you're gonna burn yourself out. So for a half marathon, to be honest, for the first one, I did not train as I should have, but I am learning from that huge mistake. Just taking it day by day. So like in the first few weeks, you know, 4 to 5 miles, maybe 3 times a week, and then up that to about 8 to 10. I try not to run an actual half marathon during my training, so I keep it between 4 and maybe 11 miles.
You can be whatever you want to be. You can do whatever you want to do. if you put your heart and soul in it, run, girl, run that mess out of this life. When your head is-